time I let them all burn.
They tried to count me out.
When that was the word,
I bring it paper,
paper, paper from the first to the first.
They count me out.
Yeah, yeah.
Now count me in.
From a city that's played host to 10 Super Bowls, here's a look inside the Superdome in New Orleans.
The setting in this dome just serves to amplify the excitement of the folks in New Orleans as their Saints burst from the tunnel a moment ago. They're set, and we're set as well as the Saints get ready to do battle with the Carolina Panthers. The kicker for the Saints, Will Lutz, has it teed up, and here we go from New Orleans. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
Come on now. Let's do this.
So first and 10 now from the 30. First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. They'll wind up getting a yard on the game's first play. It's second down.
For these two teams, they met in Charlotte earlier in the year with the Panthers coming out on top. So they'll be looking for the win here in New Orleans to complete the season sweep.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Darnold will hand off to McCaffrey. He takes this from the 30 to the 34.
Well, this defense for the Saints, they were terrific last week in the victory over Kansas City.
And the big difference in the ball game, their ability to force turnovers, 3 of them in fact. Being able to take the ball away, give it back to their offense, that's something that's emphasized each and every week, and they carried it out.
Darnold now to throw. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey, and they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
So, Charles, first drive here, a little safe completion underneath, maybe get some rhythm, get your feet wet, so to speak.
I agree, and I like it because it's a lot like a basketball game when you're getting started and you pass the ball around so everyone touches it early and gets involved in the game. In this case, it's not just dumping it to a back and he's able to run with the ball, but you get your offensive linemen involved because they get to get out and run and hit people in the open field. Everyone.
And he's taken down here by the Saints. Give the sack to David Onyemata, the product of Nigeria by way of Canada. On second down, McCaffrey. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. Third down, here's McCaffrey. McCaffrey with a first down and more. And finally taken down at the 34.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
On first down, it's Darnold. Over the middle, and there's a diving catch.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar.
You circle the Pro Bowl?
Without a doubt. That's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. And it's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
A fake to McCaffrey. Now Darnold.
Flush to his right. Goes right side. Complete to Gronk. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
Throwing again on second down. Darnold, and Hill with it over the middle. Touchdown! Tyreek Hill, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the Panthers take it right down and score on the opening drive. Gonzalez good on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Winston and the Saints now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Throwing on 2nd and 3. Winston. He's got his all-pro receiver, Michael Thomas. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. A big play there on the catch and run.
When they've needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver it. As this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent and sometimes spectacular.
Winston now to throw on 1st down. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll just get rid of it.
These two teams matching up for the 2nd time this year. Their first meeting back in October, week 6. And it was the visitors getting the win there, so they'll be looking for the sweep back here at home.
To throw on 2nd and 10. Winston. And his throw here is incomplete.
Yeah, good game catching the ball in the backfield a week ago, and they're going to try and involve him in that way in this game as well. But you can tell scouting has taken over. They're making it a little bit more difficult.
And defensively, they told us, hey, we've got to take him out of the passing game, limit it to just short runs, because he can really impact this offense.
To the air again with Winston. Well, he's going to go for it all. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. It's C.J. Henderson picking it off. There he goes, left side. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick 6 for a Panther touchdown. And this defense looking like they have come to play the pick 6, and just like that, it's 13-0 early on.
Well, go back with me to our training camp visits. What do we hear during these drills? Oh, pass. Ball. Ball's in the air.
And then my favorite.
Oski. That's the interception. That means everybody find someone to block. Block them legally. Stay on your feet. And they get it done. Touchdown.
Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT. And that'll make the score 14-0. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6. And now the kick is away. And they will not get a chance to return this one. It's through the back of the end zone for a touchback. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And last time, decent field position through the pick 6. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, that didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way down to the 35. A big-time play there for New Orleans. So that changes things a bit. Here's a 1st and 10 all the way down at the 35. Winston to give. It's Kamara. A solid run on 1st down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on 1st down, that fits the bill.
from the 29. Winston. That's to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Try to pound it in, Kamara. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Alvin Kamara, his 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Saints have cut it back within a score. Lutz with the extra point, and that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. A solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Ahead of the chains now, second and 2. A give running left, it's McCaffrey. The ball's out, McCaffrey lost it. And this is picked up by the Saints. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line.
There are two words that we hear coaches say all of the time. One starts with a B, one starts with an S, ball security.
And they preach it. They have it up in the meeting rooms, right? You see the signs. They talk about it all the time. But still, when you got defenders out there who are preaching, hey, we're going to take the ball away from you, no matter what position you play, you've got to take care of the rock.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. The Jets sweep. This is Beasley. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Throwing. Winston. Eluding the pressure right. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. So now third and 10. A big play to start the drive, but nothing since. Winston now. Rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Jeremy Chinn picks it off. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown. Gonzalez to add the PAT. It's good, and it is now 21-7. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. And following the pick six, and they had decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game because that was his longest run of this contest.
And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. We'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. It's brought in by Harris. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down.
These guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball. And what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
And he's taken down inside the 30. 41 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Flushed out right. And they'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be 2nd down.
The best quarterbacks that ever played the game all wanted to blend in with their teammates and be one of the guys. But sometimes you got to take modesty and put it aside. You're the franchise quarterback, the face of the team, and the guy that leads them to victory. You have to get down and protect yourself and not take hits like that.
From the 13 now, they work on 1st and 10. From the red zone now, Winston. Dancing to his left. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up 2nd down.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
The 2nd down throw for Winston.
That's complete to Troutman right side. And the Saints are going to be set up with a 1st and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the 1.
Now the Panthers going to use the 1st of their timeouts, as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And he takes it across and into the end zone. Touchdown, Saints. A great play there with his 16th touchdown of the year.
And the Saints get a late score here in the final minute of the first half.
Lutz good on the extra point. And that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And we'll see how they want to play this. Just a little over 20 seconds to go. Off of play action, Darnold. And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. Marcus Davenport. Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10. The Panthers going to use the 2nd of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number 1.
2nd and 20.
Another try after the 1st down sack. Darnold flush to his right. And he'll take this across the 25 before going out of bounds. A nice job of eluding the pressure there, scrambling for 11. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. A final shot before the break. Darnold, and going deep for Hill. He's got a man complete. And he'll be down deep into New Orleans territory. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. The Saints going to go on offense first, and they trail here as we begin quarter number 3. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense.
And they're on the short end of the scoreboard here. Charles, what adjustments, if any, do you think they need to make for the second half?
Well, paraphrasing the gold medal hockey winning coach Herb Brooks, I just say you continue to play your game. Throw the ball. They had success doing it in the first half. So make sure you keep getting the ball to your playmakers, a little bit more to the perimeter perhaps. But above all, play your game.
From the 30 on second down, Winston. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
They come up now third and five following the incomplete pass. Jameis to throw it. Over the middle, complete. That's Harris. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
They'll contain him to just four, second down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
On third down, Winston. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
They're going to try for it on fourth. Winston stays out there. From the gun, Winston. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Saints' decision to go for it backfires. And this defense is going to get the football back near midfield, right at the 48. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. Busts through the tackle. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42.
53 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame.
Now that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've got to hit the jackpot there.
Play action. It's Darnold. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Well, that one was all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10.
From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
I'll tell you what, this defense hasn't played its best, but they're still right in this football game. And if they keep making plays just like that, they're going to give their offense a chance.
Throwing here on third down, Darnold. And going deep for Hill. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Marcus May with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on four, turned it over in their own territory. But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
up. But
he
trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it. Be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. Now this throw caught left side, and they'll get him down up past the 15-yard line.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game, because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
And oh, Jameis intercepted a third time. Picked off by Troy Pride, and he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown. Gonzalez now to add the extra point. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. Back to it after the pick six. Winston escaping the pressure right. Now he's going to throw deep right side. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Logan Ryan. And the Panthers are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line.
I think that interception happened for two reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket and panics a little bit. And receiver doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. So there's a guy lurking, took the ball from
him. Yeah, so don't wave your arms, right, as a receiver if you're not wide open.
Got to know that you're open. Otherwise, just don't do it.
And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39. Here's second and nine. Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. He'll get about three as he's brought down right around the 42. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we play three quarters. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. The Panthers on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This will be third and six. Darnold. And going deep for Hill. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. Touchdown, Panthers. Tyreek Hill. His 10th touchdown of the season, second of the game. And the Panthers are closing in on a third straight win as they widen the gap further here in the fourth quarter. Gonzalez good on the extra point. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. This has been frustrating for them to this point. They have not looked the same as they did coming in, riding that impressive six-game win streak. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
We've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
On second and 10.
Winston eluding the pressure right. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense. First and 10. Now Winston. And now here's another interception. Jeremy Chin picks it up.
Do what we do. Do what we do.
And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown.
And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT, and that'll increase their lead to 28. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. No return there for Harris, and the drive will begin at the 25. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And you can sort of sense their dejection. That last pick six put the icing on the cake, so to speak. And a diving effort, but only right at the line of scrimmage.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
Jameis now on first down. Flushed out right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Well, we've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
And now offensively, it's third and 10, and I'm just thinking to myself, actors always say, what's my motivation before a big scene? Right now, the play caller's thinking, what have I done before that's worked well that I can go to right now?
Yeah, because they were pretty successful in the first half scoring points. Haven't done anything so far here in the second half.
To throw, Winston. The Panther was too strong. They get there and take him down. Brian Burns drops him for a loss of 12, and it also brings up fourth down. Desperation time. Winston on fourth down. And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Troy Pride. And he'll return it to the 24-yard line. What a nightmarish game he's having now. Six interceptions that he has thrown.
Absolutely unbelievable, isn't it? Hard to believe we're watching this and have seen it, but it just tells you about the game of football. It giveth and it taketh away.
Yeah, the guys, though, that have thrown six interceptions in the game, the likes of Peyton Manning, Brett Favre, I think Joe Namath, he did it three times. They're still throwing the football here, and obviously the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and try and stop any type of a running play. Short little passes may work in exchange of running plays. Keep the clock moving, keep them moving.
Yeah, I guess you're right. If they can get some first downs, just as good as running the football. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. The Panthers on third down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. This is third down and 12. Flush to his right. Going down the middle, and it's complete.
And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. Back to throw, Darnold. Buying time to his left. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
They'll go again from the three here on second and goal. McCaffrey. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
Well, where our booth is here, we can see all of the writers to our left. And their postgame stories, Charles, they have been filed for some time because this game, boy, is it lopsided.
Yeah, we can see our guy Scoop. He's even got his fedora tipped over his face. I think he's taking a nap now. Nothing left to write for him. But how gratifying has it been for them to see what they've done in practice and carry it into a game and see the execution be so good? They've got to feel fantastic about what they've accomplished in this one.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
Winston's throw here pulled in by Beasley. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. Yeah.
And now here's another interception. Picked up by Troy Prime. And the Panthers going to take over here as they get it up to the 43-yard line.
The utter domination here just continues. This defense, I don't know what more we can say all around about their performance.
Well, it certainly feels in this game like maybe they're facing a Canadian defense. 12 guys on the field. It feels like there's an extra on every snap because they have really struggled to make headway through the air.
The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise they're throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead, but I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense is going to crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well.
And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
They are certainly not letting up on the pressure in this one. And oftentimes you hear this expression, all gas, no break from defenses. But in this case, it's the offense still throwing the football up big in the fourth quarter.
Escaping the pressure right, letting one go deep for the end zone. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by the corner, Bradley Roby.
And the Saints are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line. He got out of the pocket there, was wondering what he was going to do with it, but I think he was calling. His receiver was calling for the ball, wasn't he?
He certainly was. The problem, he called for it too late, and when he delivered, they were all over him in the secondary and came up with the interception.
Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Eluding the pressure right. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. And he'll go down, but not before getting his inside the 30. A big connection on that one. 36 yards. On first and 10, Winston. The left side complete to Troutman. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in the fourth. A first down throw for Winston. Flushed out right. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
Well, I kind of got to give him credit. Another incompletion there, yes, but he's still trying to make plays outside the pocket.
Yeah, he's been hemmed in for much of the game. How about him getting outside there? And that's what you want to see from your quarterback. He's not giving up on this game, so every other player on the field has to say to himself, I can't give up either.
Throwing again, Winston on second and 10. Flush to his right. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off inside the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They're looking at a third straight win here if they can hold on. David Onyemata picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
Now this is where field awareness comes into play. He's getting perilously close to his own goal line, and after that sack, backed up to his own two.
A handoff left, McCaffrey. McCaffrey trying to escape, but he cannot. They get him in the end zone, and that's a safety.